What is going on, everybody? It is Mike. Welcome back to Tech247 TV. Glad that you're back with me today because we're going to talk about 6 tips that are going to make you more productive on your iPad. It's really going to change the way that you work with your iPad. And let's get into it. My first tip is going to be per app text sizing. Now, maybe you are like me, you know, you're getting old, your eyesight's not as good as it used to be, or maybe there are just some apps where the text inside of that app can just be a little bit bigger, a little bit more crisp. Now, per app text sizing works in both iOS and iPadOS 15, so you'll need to make sure that your app has been updated to take advantage of the newest frameworks from Apple. On all of my devices, I have my system text turned all the way down to the smallest possible size because I'm really optimizing for information density, meaning that when I'm looking at a web page or an app, I really want as much information on the screen as possible without having to shift around the image or the content at all. Now, in my example, I use Todoist, which supports iPadOS 15, and for me, the text size is just a little bit too small inside of Todoist. Now, with this feature, I can pop into Control Center, click on the text size widget, and there I'm presented with 2 options. I can either change the text size globally for all the apps, or I can actually do it on a per app basis by swiping over to the left. There you'll see that there's a toggle bar which I can drag up and drag down, which will take the system text, changing the app specifically while preserving all the other text sizes that I have either globally or on individual apps. Now there are 2 different ways to find this. First, you can enable a toggle in Control Center so that you can quickly change it system-wide or on the per app basis, which is something I just showed you, or you can go into Settings, Accessibility, and actually change it there for many apps at the same time. That in addition that you can change bold text, button shapes, on-off labels, transparency, contrast, and motion parameters either on an individual basis or globally for all the apps. This will work on both your iPhone and your iPad, and it's a great addition if you are someone maybe has low vision accessibility issues, or if you're like me and you're just getting old and your eyesight is not what it used to be. Now, next up, we're gonna talk about changes to the dock, which will improve app density. Now, when I'm using my iPad Pro, I'm almost certainly in a different productivity mode than I am when I'm using my iPad Mini. Now, since the iPad Mini is so small and the screen is so crisp, anything that is in the dock to me is gonna be what I would consider prime real estate. Meaning that I don't want anything showing in the dock that isn't necessarily relevant. Now you saw here, I have a minimized dock on this and I don't have my recent app shown. And to me, that's actually gonna be one of the critical things that make this usable on this device. I chose to disable show suggested and recent apps in the dock of my iPad Mini, allowing for the dock to be dedicated for apps to what I want to be there. And the only time that doesn't apply is when the device detects another iOS device or Mac that you are signed into and it opens up for handoff between the 2 devices. You'll see a little icon that appears depending on which app you're trying to hand off, and that works automatically. That, unfortunately, you cannot turn off. Now to change this, you're gonna go to Settings, navigate to Home Screen and Dock, and then disable Show Suggested and Recent Apps in Dock. Now as a bonus, you can even turn off Show App Library in Dock, but for me, that's not really worth it because if you disable it, you have to swipe until you get to that very last page of your apps. So I don't necessarily like turning that off, but if you wanted something a little bit cleaner, you could disable that as well. Now, this next feature I'm going to show you is a way to eliminate background noises and distractions. And to be clear, I am not referencing focus modes. If you're anything like me, you might have trouble focusing when it's time to do meaningful work because of the environment that you're in. Well, new in iPadOS 15 is the ability to play background sounds that will play either over audio or video and help eliminate distractions in your environment. Now, I'm using this in conjunction with focus modes to really accelerate my productivity to the next level as a way to eliminate environmental distractions wherever I find myself. Now, what that looks like is whenever I turn on my planning focus mode, I have a personal automation that runs that plays background sounds that sound like rain, and whenever I exit the focus mode, that background sound automatically stops. Now, I'm using this in conjunction with shortcuts, so I will put the steps on the screen, but I also will have them down in the video description below for you. You can find the configuration by navigating into Settings, Accessibility, and then Audio and Visual. There you can choose between Ocean, Rain, Stream, Bright Noise, Dark Noise, or a balance of all of them. Now, as I said in the beginning, you can actually have this playing either by itself or on top of any media that you choose to, and you can have it stop when your iPad is locked. Now, once you have it set up, let's head over to the Shortcuts app. Click on the plus button to create a new shortcut and name your shortcut however you want to. From the search bar, let's type in background and select set background sound. Now you should see the action turn background sounds on in the shortcut action pane on the left-hand side. Tap on turn and then change it to toggle. Then click on done in the top right-hand corner. Next, we're gonna automate the shortcut so whenever you enter into a focus mode, it will automatically turn on or turn off that background sound for you so you don't have to worry about turning it on and turning it off every time that you want to. Still within shortcuts, look at the left-hand navigation bar and tap on automation. tap on the plus button, and then select Create Personal Automation. Now, when you create a personal automation, that is something that only runs on your device. If you have an iPhone and an iPad, you'd have to set up the automation separately on both devices. Now, this brings up a series of triggers that you can choose from. Swipe all the way to the bottom and find the focus mode that you want to customize. On this next screen, you want to make sure that you have turn on and when turning off are both checkmarked. Hit next, tap add action, type shortcut in the action search bar, now select run shortcut, type in the name of the new shortcut that you created and then tap next. Now before clicking save, make sure that you disable ask before running, because if you don't, every time you go to run the shortcut, what's gonna happen is that your iPad will ask you that you'll need to confirm yes or no whether you wanna run the shortcut before doing so. This is so annoying. Hopefully Apple fixes this in some future version of iPadOS. Click done, and what you'll wanna do is verify that the shortcut is working. You can do that simply by going into focus modes and enabling the shortcut that you customize there. And once you do that, you should hear the background sounds play. And if you stop that focus mode, it should stop the background sounds as well. Now you should remember that if you enabled the background sound to play over media, that media does include any media. So it could be audio or visual. So if you happen to be in a focus mode, watching YouTube or watching Hulu, whatever the case is, it will play that background sound underneath that audio or video. So you might just keep that in mind. Now, if you have any other questions about focus modes, let me know down in the comments below, because I was considering redoing my focus mode video that I did at the beginning of the summer, and I'd be more than happy to address any questions that you have in a future video. Now, new in iOS and iPadOS 15 are gonna be enhanced services if you're using an iPad that has 5G, like an iPad Pro 2021, or even the iPad mini, but also if you have an iPhone 12 or an iPhone 13, this would apply to you as well. Now, with these enhanced services, you can back up your device over 5G, perform a device update, make and receive FaceTime HD calls, in addition to downloading higher quality audio and video content over the 5G cellular network while using your device. And if you have an iPad Pro 2021, you can connect your device to the 5G network and your device will actually prioritize 5G over Wi-Fi when you have an unstable Wi-Fi connection. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, Mike, I would never spend the money to get a 5G connection on my iPad Pro, iPad Mini, I certainly understand that, but what I would suggest is that you at least watch my video where I talk about the benefits of having 5G on an iPad, iPad Mini, iPad Pro. Here, I'll link it in the card above. Now to find this, you're gonna navigate into settings, you're gonna click on cellular data, and then you're gonna go to cellular data options. You're gonna tap on data in the first selection, and then change it to 5G on. This means that your device will choose 5G whenever it's available. Go back one screen, choose cellular data options, which is right below it, and then choose allow more data on 5G. Apple did a lot of optimization in iOS and iPadOS 15 for 5G, really taking the heavy lifting away from developers, allowing them to worry about how their app functions and not necessarily about the radio transport options or how it works on either wireless or the cellular network. Now you might see a slight dip in battery performance depending on what 5G coverage looks like for you at your house, like where I live. 5G coverage is actually pretty abysmal where I live, but in and around my community, it's actually very good. So I don't mind turning it on and having that hit, because when I'm out and about, having the fastest, most secure connection is what I am prioritizing. Now, next up is be QUICKNOTES. And this is a feature that's new in iPadOS and macOS Monterey that allows you to swipe up from the bottom right-hand corner to quickly capture notes, content, etc. into the Notes app without actually having the Notes app open. Additionally, if you're taking notes while using Safari, you can highlight content from the website and then drag them into your QUICKNOTE or by using the contextual menu. Now, I use this feature all the time to collect information related to research for my day job where I work in IT for an enterprise software company. It makes the collection process super straightforward because I can title my QUICKNOTE based on my search terms, or I could just add the search term into my note as well, and I can add photos and handwritten text into the note itself. Now, as a bonus, in iPadOS 15.2, which you can configure the swipe up function from the bottom left hand or the bottom right hand corner to identify what that behavior is. And if you're familiar with it right now, if you swipe up from the bottom left, it's gonna take a screenshot. If you swipe up from the bottom right, it does open QUICKNOTES. Depending on when you are watching this video, this feature might not be available yet, but it is in 15.2 beta, so you should see it before the end of 2021 or maybe early 2022 at the very latest. Now, my sixth and final productivity tip for you is a doozy. This is about multitasking. Now, we all know iPadOS 15 redefined the multitasking menu. Now, if you wanna multitask, there are these three glyphs at the top of every screen. It allows you to choose how you want to multitask and with what app. Also new in iPadOS 15 is the ability to split screen apps by using a shortcut. Now, I don't know about you, but I split screen same apps very frequently depending on what my action is. I am often using apps, let's say like Todoist, and my calendar every morning before I do my review, what to do. Now this is a real time saver because I can actually also tie it to focus modes. So whenever I enable my focus mode, not only is it gonna turn on the background sounds that we talked about a few minutes ago, but it's also gonna automatically open these apps in split screen, and it's not just a 50-50 split view. You can change them to be 3/4, 1/4, 1/4, 3/4, 50-50. It doesn't really matter. There's a lot of configuration options there. But it is a real time saver, especially if you always have these actions done while you're doing certain activities. That, in addition to another feature coming in 15.2, is the ability when you choose to do a split view app, you can actually select which side of the pane you want the split view app, just like you can on the Mac. And then you can swap them interchangeably. A lot of neat tricks. Now, I don't know about you, but I hope that you found something valuable in today's video. And if you have, let me know in the comments below what you were able to take away from this video and hopefully incorporate it into your own workflow. Now, if you want to be one of the first to watch my iPad mini accessory video when it comes out, which I promise it is coming out, I'm waiting for a few more things. Make sure you are subscribed, turn on notifications so you can be one of the first people to watch that. My name is Mike. This is Tech 24/7 TV. Folks, I will talk to you in the next one.